Hi, my name is Deb Rockney, and I'm the owner and operator of Lucine Stable in Watertown, Minnesota.
Since 1983, so it's been 32 years in the business. We bought this place because of its proximity to the trail on a non-busy dirt road, and it seemed to suit us real well for boarding horses.
What I really like about the Lucine Stables is that, first of all, when I looked here, I liked having the Lucine Trail right across the street.
I always knew I wanted to work with horses, so I went to the University of Minnesota way back in the 70s and earned a Bachelor of Science degree in the field of animal science with a special interest in the nutrition of large animals.
Second of all, Rudy was a rescue horse. And so when I decided to board him here, I found out the owner, Deb Rockney, had a degree in equine nutrition, so that made a big difference to me.
I make it my business to keep current on horse health issues. Based on my research, I feed only non-GMO grain, a mixture of corn and oats with a mineral supplement I buy from a local feed mill. We feed only small square bales. It's more expensive and more work than feeding the large round bales, but well worth it because it's healthier for the horses.
My name is Jason Weinberg. My wife and I board two horses here. I have nothing but good things to say about having the other horses here. They're really doing well.
There's three of us that do the barn work here, and all of us live on site.
That's what I really, really like about it. It's having someone here all the time.
And the stalls are cleaned right away in the morning.
She's even got the cameras looking on the paddocks and everything.
They have cameras, a surveillance system, so even if I did leave, I could view my pastures and paddocks from wherever I was.
I'm sure she's in the house before going to bed looking to see how the horses are doing, so it's kind of 24/7, you know, somebody's looking after them and taking care of them.
If a horse gets sick, we can put a camera on him and watch him all night. I also have a monitor in my bedroom so that I can just wake up, look at the camera, see that the horse is all right. We've used this a couple of times for different reasons, so that's coming very handy.
There's an emergency. He has colicked in the past once. I got a call right away. Deb found it. The owner found it right away, so we were able to get that taken care of.
My name is Stacy, and I've been coming out to Lucine Stable since I was about 8 years old, and now I have a son, Dylan, who is 10, who's been coming out here since he was 8 years old. What I like the best about Lucine Stables are the little extras. There's an outside wash stall, so when your horse is hot and sweaty and you've been riding all day, it's great because you can wash them off and get them feeling great.
Last year we added this heated groom room off the indoor riding ring. It's a great place to spend time with your horse during the winter months, but it's especially beneficial when the vet or farrier needs to come out.
It's wonderful because you can stay warm, they can be warm, and it's a safe enclosed area.
Before the vet would come out, he'd say, my equipment won't work in the cold. They couldn't take the x-rays. Now we can do everything here, and they spend a lot more time if they're warm. The Lucine Stable property is 40 acres. We have both box stall horses and pasture horses. Both groups have access to pasture 12 hours a day during the summer months, and the property is divided into smaller pastures that we rotate throughout the summer. All horses have access to shelter when outdoors, which allows us to minimize the time the box stall horses are in their stalls.
They also take the horses in really late and bring them out real early in the morning, so they aren't stuck in a stall all day.
We try to do more of a natural life for the horses here and keep them outside as much as possible. Typically, they're let out by 7 a.m. and remain outdoors until 9 p.m., which means they are happier horses. We have somebody on site that gives lessons. Also, you can bring your own instructor in if they're insured. I've kind of catered here to the pleasure rider. Because of that, I have a lot of long-term boarders.
I've been here 10 years now. August 5th, there'll be 10 years. As you can see, Rudy's not a skinny rescue horse anymore.
The atmosphere here is kind of family-friendly. People don't have to worry about competing. Most of the people here do trail riding. Some of them will dabble a little bit in dressage or team penning. All in all, everybody's kind of like a little family here.
There's great people here. It's not a real fancy show barn, just a lot of fun. You've got people of all ages. Everybody's very casual, no fancy footwork here.
One of the great things about the barn and the people here is it's just a real laid-back environment. And all the people that that we know in the area and that we hang out with, we've really met through the barn.
I really like that there's a clubhouse. Loose Line Stables is more than just a stable, it's a community. After riding all day, oftentimes you'll find a group of people gathered there, sharing drinks and stories and some food, and it just makes for an extra special experience.
Plus, I love the outdoor arena.
In the spring, summer, and fall, the outdoor arena is extremely large too. Whether it's just pleasure or doing barrels or if you wanted to do some roping, it seems like there's plenty of room.
They've got the indoor arena.
Big indoor arena, which horses get plenty of work in the wintertime. Besides just the facilities, the location, you can just ride for miles and miles. And so even if you don't have a trailer and can't bring your horses to one of the county parks, the Loose Line's right here and more than enough places to ride besides just in the arenas.
Just couldn't be happier with it. But I know Rudy likes it, so I guess that's what matters.
My horse had never put on too much weight. He's never looked as good as he looks right now, never had the weight and the muscle on. That's one of the things here that you never have to worry about. I don't think there's a single horse here that looks like they're either sick or not getting enough feed. And
I really don't have anything bad to say about this place.
We just don't have enough good things to say about the Loose Line Stables and Deb and what she's been able to do for us and for our horses.